Hello kids, how are you all? So wishing you an awesome day. So stay healthy and stay happy at home, okay? So today we are going to begin with a new session of your English Literature's Chapter 4, Two Silly Goats. So what can you understand from the very word silly? Two silly goats. But before going into the chapter, let me show you some pictures of goats. I hope you know what goats are, isn't it, children? Can you see two goats in this picture? See here, a real one. Can you see its tail? It's very tiny, isn't it? Compared to that of a cows and a dogs, it's tiny. Look at its horns. How are its horns? Now, another picture. What about this one? It's curly, it's twisted backside, isn't it? So these are pictures of goats. Now we are going to learn a beautiful story about two goats having a very twisted and big horns. And this story is happening in a village. Now the name of our story is Two Silly Goats. What is the name of its chapter? Repeat after me. Two Silly Goats. Can you see the picture of two goats here trying to cross a bridge? Isn't it? Now, here the story begins. Now, listen carefully. Okay. Once upon a time, in a lovely, beautiful village, there lived many people. And there was one speciality for the village. There was a beautiful river passing through it. And there was a bridge over it, and what was special about the bridge was it was very narrow. See, when you pass a bridge, there's enough space for vehicles to pass by to and fro, isn't it? But here, whereas in this bridge, it was very narrow, only a person at a time could walk through it. No vehicles can pass by, no two people can even pass by. Only one person can cross the bridge at a time. So what will happen if two or more people comes to the bridge to pass at the both ends? So maybe one have to wait till the other passes by and then the people can cross the bridge. But this village, the people of this village lived in peace and harmony. They loved each other. And then when anybody used to come, some or the other will wait till the other one passes. And there were no fight for the bridge for the people to pass. There were no fight for the way. But there were two goats in that village. You know, these two goats looked similar in their size, in their color, about their horns and their faces. They looked very similar. But you know what? These goats were very proud of themselves. These goats were selfish. They thought that they were the first human beings. Okay. They were the first animal. They were better than the others. And they were proud of themselves. So, you know what happened one day? One fine morning, one of the goat came from one side, the other from the other side. And they started to walk over the bridge at the very same time. So, I told you only a person can pass through the bridge at a time. So, when they met at the middle of the bridge, what do you think might have happened? See, both of them, I told you, they were proud of themselves. They said, "Who are you? Move away from my way. I need to cross the bridge." So the other was telling, "No, no, not me. You have to move away. Please move away from my way. I have the right of the way. Come on, I want to cross the bridge." And they started calling each other bad words also. And you know what? They began a big fight. They were fighting with each other with their horns. They were pushing and shoving. And then what happened? Both of the goats fell into the river and they drowned and they died. Okay, so never be proud of yourselves. Adjust with others and give way for others. Considerate, be considerate. Consider the others also. Understood. So this message conveys a beautiful, this story conveys a beautiful message also. Okay, so that is the story. Now take your worksheet in your hand, page number 17. Now we are going to have a reading. I'll read the story for you. You need just to listen to me carefully. Okay. Two silly goats. Now on to the chapter. Point your finger and run through the lines. Once upon a time, there lived two silly goats in a lovely village. They looked alike, but they were both very selfish and proud. Each of them thought themselves to be very great. Second paragraph. A beautiful river flowed past the village. There was a bridge across a river, but the bridge was very narrow. It was so narrow that only one person or animal can pass at a time. But it wasn't a problem for people and some other animals. When two people came across a bridge at the same time, one would just wait a minute until the other one crossed over, and then they would cross over safely. All the animals of the village also followed that rule. However, these two silly goats were quite different. One day, they came to the opposite ends of the bridge at the same time. Although they saw each other at the opposite ends, they just continued to try to cross a bridge at the same time. Each in its own pride thought they had the right of way and that the other goat should yield away. Naturally, the silly goats met in the middle of the bridge. And what do you think happened? Each goat refused to move. Both of them stood their ground. Neither wanted to take back nor make way for the other. "Hey, you," cried the first goat. "Get out of my way. Don't you see I am trying to cross a bridge?" "You silly fellow, who do you think you are talking to? You make way for me at once," cried the second one. They yelled and started pushing each other. When the two silly goats started pushing and shoving each other, they got into a big fight right on the narrow bridge. They both fell down into the river and died. So you listen to the story, right? That was a wonderful story, a beautiful story. Now let's move on to the meanings, the new words in our story. Listen carefully, children. What is the first word given here? Narrow. Repeat after me. Narrow. N-A-R-R-O-W. Narrow. Repeat. Now, what is the meaning of narrow? Children, when I say repeat, you have to repeat the spelling after me. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of narrow? Not wide. I told you it is not wide, a big one. It's a small, a narrow way. Not wide or broad. Not wide or broad. It's narrow. Now, repeat the meaning after me. Narrow. Not wide or broad. Narrow. Not wide or broad. Now, second one. Yield. What's the meaning of yield? To give up. See, both the goats were coming and asking the others to yield, to move away, to go away from the bridge because they wanted to pass it. Okay, so yield means to go away, to give up. Come on, move away, give up, okay. So, repeat after me, yield, to give up, yield, to give up. Next one, refused. Repeat children, refused. What do you mean by refusing? Sometimes, for example, I'll tell you, you are sleeping in the morning. So after your sleep in the morning, you have to naturally get up. Your mama comes and call you. See, it is early morning, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, come on, get up. And what do you do? No, mama, there's no school nowadays. So please, I'm sorry, I'm not going to get up. Please, 5 more minutes, 10 more minutes, you say. You're refusing to get up. Okay, you're saying a no. No, I do not want to get up. Okay, or sometimes your mama might prepare some veggies for you. Some veggies you might not like. So you refuse. No, I do not want these vegetables. Isn't it? So, to show that one is not willing to do something. Okay, you're showing your willingness. No, you're not showing. You are refusing. Okay, now repeat after me. Refused. To show that one is not willing to do something. Okay, your next word, showing. What is showing? In the last paragraph, you have discussed about, see, when the two silly goats started pushing and showing each other. What do you mean by showing? You are forcefully pushing somebody. Okay, now listen here. To push someone forcefully. When you have fight with your brothers and sisters, what do you do? Sometimes you push them forcefully and the other might fall down. Sometimes you might fall down, isn't it? So, why did you fall down? You have got a forceful push, isn't it? So, that is what is meant here. Showing is a new word for you. You can keep in account. Okay. Repeat. Showing. S-H-O-V-I-N-G. Showing. To push someone, repeat, forcefully, once more, to push someone forcefully. So these are our new words. Now we are moving on to a small match the following. But here you have some words which are opposites. For example, hot, cold, tall, short. Okay, I have given questions here, but answers I have given jumble. So, you have to find out the answer and match it. And when you match, do not draw lines like this. Okay, I do not want you to draw lines. It gives you a shabby image. So, number one is proud. When you find the answer to proud, what do you have to do? Near to the answer, you have to write the number of that particular question. Understood? Now let's read this. Read. Proud. Proud. Narrow. Different. Push. Now read with spelling. P-R-O-U-D. Proud. N-A-R-R-O-W. Narrow. D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-T, different. P-U-S-H, push. So, these are the words. Now, let's see to the answers. WIDEY. PULL. Pull. Ashamed. 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 SAME. Same. So these are the words. Proud. What is the meaning of proud? You're proud of yourself. So when you does a mistake, what do? You feel ashamed, isn't it? Now let's find out whether the word ashamed is here. White. White. Pull. Ashamed. So you have here ashamed, isn't it? Now near to ashamed, mark number 1, since this is the answer for number 1, and just give a circle. Understood. Now next word, narrow. Narrow. Opposite of narrow is, see in the previous page you have, narrow means not wide. So the opposite of narrow is wide. Just find out the word wide. See, first itself we have wide. Number 2, and then circle. Okay. Number 3 is different. It is different. It is a same. See, two words left for us are pull and same. So here same. Number 3. Okay. Now the last word is push. You're pushing somebody, you're pulling somebody. Understood? You're pushing somebody, you're pulling somebody. Now pull. Number 4. Understood? So I hope you are well versed with the chapter, children. Keep reading the chapter also. Now in the notes you have, we have marked difficult words for you. So refer to the notes, mark the difficult words or new words and learn it with the spelling. Please write and learn it with the spelling. Okay, so I hope the story is clear to you. Wait for the next video, children, and stay safe and happy at home until we meet in the next video. Bye.